really, really impressed with your guys' office. Honestly, there's not one guy in here that isn't completely sharp that I wouldn't kill to take three of you guys and go start it. I can launch a branch with just one of you guys, so good job. What was working for me, I'm going to tell you something that you hear all the time, and it's what's going to work in this business, no matter how you look at it, and it's the numbers game. You got to go out there, you got to hit enough doors, right? You know, some well, some won't, who cares who's next? Move on, get as many no's out of the way. Let them, you know, threaten to call the cops, kick you out before you leave if you have to. But go out there and hit as many people as you can. That's always what's going to work for you. I mean, it's a really, really simple concept. You talk to enough people. I could walk into 100 doors, say, I'm selling, you buying. Somebody's going to say, well, what are you selling? And then I can pitch you. Right? It's a numbers game. So when I have enough offices, I'm actually going to take a week, go out there and pitch people. I'm selling, you buying, I guarantee I'll still come back and outproduce the guy that's being lazy and not hitting enough doors. Can I get a come on?
Come on!
There we go. All right.
Get some.
Who's it?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Who's away?
Yeah.
He's fired up.
Yeah.
Ready to win.
Yeah.
Ready to make money.
Yeah.
To get it.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about now. Number one in the entire United States. Can I get a come on?
Come on!
All right. You guys want to know my ultimate secret to success?
What's that?
All right. You guys are already doing it, but I think you can step it up to the next level. What's step seven to the 8 steps of success?
Know why you're here
and what you're doing, aka having goals. This is my favorite thing in the world to talk about, okay? Because goals, I can honestly tell you, is exactly what has given me the success that I've had. Right, I've been with MSD for 2 years. I got a phone call, literally sold all my stuff. I was living in Florida, went back home to Seattle in the rainy season, and all I knew was I was going to go through the program, become an owner, go open up offices. So from, well, before I even started MSD, but from the first month I went there, you got to have your goals, right? I could go back for the last couple years. Every month on the night before the first, I rewrite my goals for the month, okay? You got to write down your goals. You guys got your notepads, right?
Yeah.
Let me tell you guys how to really utilize step seven. Know why you're here and what you're doing. All right, you can read any self-help book. You can listen to Zig Ziglar, Anthony Robbins, any of these self-help, really successful people, Pawnee. They'll tell you have to have your roadmap to success. You have to know why you're here and what you're doing. If you don't know why you're here, then what are you doing here? If you want to go out there and make $50, that's easy. If you want to come here and run a branch, be partners with Pawnee in this business, then you have to have that as a goal, right? So step one, know what you want. All right, so the second step is where it actually becomes tangible, it actually becomes physical. It's where you write your goals. You've got to write your goals down. If you think about it, you know, you can know what you want. You know, I want to make $100 today. But when you write that down, now it's something you can touch. It's on a piece of paper. You can actually see it. So that's the first step of taking something that's a thought and turning it into something physical and tangible. Okay, so you write down your goals. Step three, what are you willing to sacrifice to get that goal? Right? While everyone else is sleeping in on a Saturday, if you're going for assistant manager and you need apps, you know, if you have that in your goals, I'm willing to sacrifice my Saturday afternoon to go out there and go the extra mile, make it happen so that I'm one step closer. You know, if you're serious about this business, this is a 6-day minimum job if you're serious about going out there and running a branch, and then more when you're on Pawnee and myself's level, 7 days a week, but you get the benefits from it as well. Okay? Step four, you got to be very, very specific. Right? If you want a car, I want a new car by January 2012. Well, what kind of car do you want? What color is it? Is it a 4-door car? Do you want a Volvo or do you want a Porsche, right? You got to be very specific. Personally, some of my personal goals next year, I want a house. That's not good enough for me. I could go buy a house in the hood tomorrow if I wanted to, but that's not good enough. I want a 4-bedroom house. It's going to be a beige, and it's going to be on the beach with a hot tub, a swimming pool, and there's going to be palm trees in it, right? Specific. I have pictures of the houses that match my criteria on a vision board. Right, I know what I'm working for. When I go out in the field or I'm at the office doing interviews, I can tell you exactly what I'm going to have. Okay, and the last step is, what's the difference between a wish and a goal?
A deadline.
Date of achievement is the difference between a wish and a goal. When do you want to be an owner? When do you want to be promoted to leadership? What are you going to do to get there? Okay, so I'll give you some examples going back, because right now I'm out of management mode. I got myself into agent mode. So something that I do every single month is write my goals. right? So for you, let's say you're going for a system manager. You know what you need to do. How many apps or how much money do you have to make over a month, Lonnie?
$4,000 with your team.
$4,000 with your team, okay? So you can break that down day by day, right? When you look at the big picture, it seems so far away. But you break it down to the day. So you got to write down, I will hit a system manager by February 2012. In order to get this, I'm going to work 6 days a week and hit every single door in my way. I'm going to sacrifice my lunches. I won't eat unless I have 3 apps in my binder. Okay? On top of that, kind of lost my thought there. Pumped up. But, you know, just knowing what you want and where you're going with it. I mean, literally, I just wrote a lesson for MSD, and it's about knowing what you want and where you're going. Right? I can go back to the very first month when I started in this program. And it says, I'm here to learn this business, go through the program, in 12 months I'll be in Miami running an office, right? The next month, I was leader. Okay, from leader, I'm going to build a team. I'm going to go out, I'm going to do this. Every day before I go out in the field, I can tell you how much money I'm going to make and how many deals I'm going to have because I have it written down. Ron, what's the first thing I do before I leave the hotel every single day?
He reads his goal sheet every single morning.
Out loud.
Out loud. Sometimes in the mirror, looking at himself.
I'm going to make this much money. I'm going to make that much at this many deals, and I'm not going to stop short of my goals, right? My number one is my family. That's my top reason. My number two is travel. I like to have fun. Number three is business. Any reason why number three would be business and not number one? Because my family and traveling is my why. Your why is always going to be 99% more powerful than just saying, no, I want to go make a couple dollars. So what's more powerful, waking up in the morning with a good attitude, you guys are all jacked up, which is fucking awesome, but what's more powerful, doing that, or actually waking up before you come to the office, saying, I'm going to go out and sign 3 deals, I'm going to go out and write $2,000 in profit, I'm going to, and I'm not going to stop until I do. What's more powerful, having a good attitude or waking up knowing what you're going to do and having a good attitude? What's more powerful?
Waking up and knowing.
Can I get a drum roll?
Come on!
That's what's up. All right, yeah. So one of my goals that I've had since I went to Seattle, coming back to Florida to open up an office, was something that a couple people in here are going to have the honor of coming and joining me, Pawnee, and the MSD crew, which is going skydiving in southern Florida. All right? That's been one of my goals. I can go to my first goal sheet, and that was one of my goals on there. It got me through so many Saturdays up in Washington when it was raining, people telling me to get lost, whatever. I remember one day I was out in the field for 4 hours. No. Territory beat up. Who cares? I've never been there, right? So I kept going. I ended up going out there writing 4 deals in the last, like, hour and a half. Because what was in my mind as I'm hitting doors, I'm sitting there thinking, in 1 year, I'm going to be skydiving in southern Florida, and these jerks are going to be up here running their business in the rainy Northwest, and I'm going to be skydiving in Florida. Pretty simple. I know my why, and it's what keeps me going and keeps me motivated. So this weekend, this Sunday, we are going out. We call it Extreme Day. It's something that me and my partner Dustin started with MSD. Once a month, we do an Extreme Team Day. Right, it's kind of a mind over matter thing. So this weekend we are going to go skydiving. Who here has been skydiving? Couple of people. You been, Joey? Mm-hmm. Awesome. This is not something you want to miss. Okay. So everyone, who's down for skydiving?
Hell yeah!
All right. This is extreme day. If skydiving scares the shit out of you, congratulations, you're human. That's why this is a mind over matter exercise. Because once you jump out of that plane, it helps you. So. So Extreme Day, we do it every single month. So MSD, obviously we're all going. Now here's what we're going to do, and I'll let Pine promote how he wants to do his. As far as the 3 MSD crew that's out working with us right now, whoever goes out there and writes the most apps is going to be invited to come. Okay? Extreme Day is for the big boys. Typically it's the system managers and owners in our program. But that doesn't mean that is what it is, right? So, but it is for the big boys, for people that are excited, that want to go out and do something extreme. So, Vanessa, John, Joey, most apps, you're invited to come. If 2 people tie, then, you know, both of you come, but somebody's got to go out there and win, because there's no second place. That's just first and second place. So, Pawnee, promote how you want
to... Same thing with Crow guys, whoever high rolls, that's apps, we're not doing prop. Whoever high rolls gets to come also to skydiving. It's going to be a pretty cool experience. Obviously, you can tell it's an exciting thing. You know, if you're scared, Me too. It's going to be fun. It's going to be an awesome time. Time to get uncomfortable and do something you've never done. So high roller in apps, right? Add-ons, rebuys count. Let's squat smash. That's going to help us get to number one. That's and tough. Also someone's going to jump out of a fucking plane.
Yeah!
All right, so let's have...
Hell yeah.
So let's have fun with it. I'm going to end it on this note. I do these... I talk about goals all the time, right? Some people take it serious, some people don't. You guys believe... Who believes in the law of attraction? Okay, now when you write your goals, right, and you have them on paper, and you read them every day, every single day, and you talk about hitting the system manager, and it's always on your brain, you know, how many days does it take to form a habit? Does anyone know? 21 days. So if you read your goals every single day after 21 days, they're going to be in your subconscious mind, no matter how you look at it, right? So then you not only know what you want and what you're doing, but the universe knows what you want and what you're doing, and it's going to start attracting that to you. Right? It's work smarter, not harder. And law of attraction is no easier way in the world to get what you want. And you do that by knowing what you want. And in this business, know what you want and why you're doing it. So know your why. MSD guys, definitely mandatory as far as working with us. Tonight I want you to write down your goals day by day. How many deals are you going to have next week? How many leases? How much money are you going to make? Okay? Break it down day by day. I want to see those every single day. You should be reading them before you come to the office. You guys have been in the car with me. I have my little sheet there about I control my life. I make my own money. It's up to me to do this. So that's mandatory for the rest of you guys. If you really want to be the number one office, I promise you not everyone in LA is utilizing this. Not even 10%. Everyone in here does that. You will crush everyone. Next week, next month, every single month if you know what you want and this is your business, I would highly recommend it. That's my secret to success. Overall, not just yesterday. So, thanks for your time.
Yeah. All right, so real quick, guys, MSP guys are going to be hitting it. Obviously, we got a lot to learn. So, car rides are as follows. Vanessa and Darcy, you have your map. We have Joe going out with Joey, and then we have Ron and John going out there. Let's make it happen. MSP guys, good to go. Let's give them a round of applause. Let's go.